From mountains so dangerous no one has ever reached the top, to a mountain that had the tendency to simply make the climber disappear, we take a look at 10 of the deadliest mountains in the world. Number 10. Broad Peak, Pakistan. Fatality rate, 5%. This mountain, the 12th largest in the world, acquired its name due to a mile-long ridge around the summit. A debate rages about the true peak of the mountain, as climbers typically stop at one of two summits. One of them, 8,015 meters high, the other, 8,047 meters tall. The legendary Hermann Buhl led a team of Austrian mountaineers to the peak on June 5, 1957, becoming the first to reach the top of this mountain. This was the second time Hermann became the first human to scale a peak in the 8,000-meter club. Number 9. Shishapangma, Nepal. Fatality rate, 8%. Shishapangma was the last of the 8,000-meter mountains to be conquered by humanity when a team of Chinese climbers reached the top in 1964. Despite being the last of the 8,000 club to be summited, Shishapangma is labeled as one of the less challenging climbs, even though 8% of people who attempt to climb this mountain die on slope. One of the most amazing feats of climbing was accomplished by Yuli Steck on this mountain, who reached the 8,013 meter peak in an astoundingly quick 10.5 hour climb. Number 8. Makalu, Nepal, China. Fatality rate, 9%. The path to remote Makala is a lengthy march fraught with peril. This journey to the base of the mountain is just the beginning of an 8,481 meter climb that's sometimes compared to the treachery of the notorious K2. Makala is the fifth biggest mountain in the world and one of the most difficult to summit. Similar to K2, a significant portion of fatalities occur while climbers descend the mountain. Part of the lethality of the peak lies with the shape of the top, a steep, four-sided pyramid that features near-constant storm activity rife with shifting ice. Number 7. Gasherbrum 1, Pakistan. Fatality rate, 9%. The only reason that Gasherbrum 1, which means beautiful mountain, doesn't have a greater rate of death among climbers is the fact that only the very best typically dare to think about visiting and conquering this remote challenge. Nestled among a six-pack of peaks, towering 8,068 meters above sea level, the first ascent of Gasherbrum 1 was completed in 1958 by an eight-man American team with a pair of the climbers, Pete Shaning and Andy Kaufman, using mirrors to communicate success with the rest of the expedition. Number 6. Manaslu, Nepal. Fatality rate, 10%. Called the Mountain of the Spirit, Manaslu is the eighth tallest mountain on Earth and frequently exposes its climbers to landslides and monsoons, in addition to the usual danger of falling ice and avalanches. This 8,156 meter climb was first achieved in 1956 by a team of Japanese mountaineers, a feat no one dared replicate until 1971 when another Japanese squad reached the peak. Unlike many other routes, the technical difficulty and danger due to avalanche decrease slightly the higher one climbs. Number 5. Kanchenjunga, India, Nepal. Fatality rate, 15%. Despite advances in technology that help increase safety on fearsome peaks, Kanchenjunga means consistently deadly, with fatality rates climbing above 1 in 5 during the 1990s while the world's other dangerous mountains became statistically safer. Anyone climbing this mountain exposes themselves to one of the most dangerous environments on Earth. Weather conditions are shifty and treacherous on Kanchenjunga, and predictably unpredictable avalanches take place with little to no warning. Number 4. Dhaulagiri 1, Nepal. Fatality rate, 16%. This mountain, the seventh tallest on Earth at 8,167 meters, has a habit of simply disappearing even the most experienced climbers. The south face of Dhaulagiri 1 has never been climbed and is considered a suicidal ascent by expert mountaineers. Similar to most gigantic peaks, the danger of avalanches poses the greatest threat to climbers. Of the mountains taller than 8,000 meters, Dhaulagiri 1 was the second last to be conquered, the first ascended by a team of two Sherpa with Austrian and Swiss mountaineers. Number 3. Nanga Parbat, Kashmir. Fatality rate, 21%. Nanga Parbat is the ninth biggest mountain in the world, nicknamed the Man-Eater because of the severity of challenge that climbers face. Many who perished on this mountain did so before the first successful route was found in 1953 by Hermann Buell. 31 previous attempts had ended in death. Buell, considered one of the best ever climbers, ascended 8,126 meters without an ice axe or oxygen, sleeping while standing on a narrow ledge with a single handhold anchoring him to the precipice. After spending 40 hours climbing, he became the first to conquer the Man-Eater. Number 2, K2, Pakistan, China. Fatality rate, 29%. K2 is a legendary peak and the second tallest mountain in the world, only a few hundred meters shorter than Mount Everest. However, due to the difficulty of the 8,611-meter climb and notoriously unpredictable ice, K2 is far, far more dangerous than Everest. Most attempt to conquer K2 from the Pakistani side of the mountain rather than from the Chinese side of the rock. The bottleneck portion of the route is the most treacherous, consisting of wild weather, shifting ice pillars, and avalanches that may strike at any time. Number 1. Annapurna 1, Nepal. Fatality rate, 34%. Located in the northern region of central Nepal, Annapurna 1 is a death wish that kills more than a third of the people who attempt to climb this lethal summit. One of the latest tragedies occurred in October of last year, when 39 souls passed away after a series of deadly avalanches and snowstorms. The south face of this mountain is considered one of the most difficult and technical climbs in the world, made even more dangerous by the region's susceptibility to avalanches. Only 191 people have conquered Annapurna 1, while 52 climbers have passed away during the 8,091-meter ascent. 9 climbers have died while making their descent from the mountain. If you like this video, why not hit that like button? And remember to hit the subscribe button for more videos every 2 days.